of awe and admiration at the way you have fought your battle. And it has been a peaceful battle, a firm battle, and a resolute battle. It's a battle for justice. And I believe after what happened on March 22nd, 2016, that the Hyderabad Central University has become the fulcrum of the anti-caste movement in this country. We lost Rohit on 17th of January. And I think it's a matter of shame that after the letter of December 18th, such a man who occupies the chair of the Vice Chancellor can be shameless enough to still occupy that. He was appealed to by Rohit. He was given sufficient warning to dialogue with his students. He showed the arrogance of position, arrogance of caste, and arrogance of class. And arrogance of impunity because he is backed by the powerful in Delhi. What happened on March 22nd, friends, could not have happened but for the backing of the MHRD and the PMO. Clearly, the message is that universities will be made into war zones, particularly if university students ask for justice. And I would like to begin by saluting Professor Ratnam and Professor Tathagata Sengupta, who have stood like a rock with the students of this university. And I also would like to salute the other faculty who are standing with the students, and appeal to the rest to stand on the side of justice and not to stand on the side of power. This is a moment of speaking truth to power. Speaking truth to power. और हमें ये कहना पड़ेगा कि आप यूनिवर्सिटी को बाहर रख सकते हैं, मगर सड़कों से तो बाहर नहीं रख सकते. सड़क हमारी है या आसमान हमारा है. और अगर JNU में एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ब्लॉक के अंदर लेक्चर हुए, अगर अंदर आप लेक्चर नहीं करवाएंगे तो हम बाहर आके भी हम हर दिन लेक्चर देने के लिए करें. Kindly invited by the faculty to meet the students and to give a lecture. But some of us who stand for democracy and social justice are a big threat to the Modi regime in Delhi. What my greatest regret today is that I could not pay tribute at Delhi Wada. I wanted to go to the Delhi Wada, which was the seat and the sign of protest where 5 students who were denied access to the library, denied access to the mess, denied access to life and dignity, were sleeping out in the open in January before Rohit Dalmia's institutional order. Students, you have shown a lot of responsibility. You wanted things to come back to normal. The acting Vice Chancellor Perisamy sir was dialoguing with the students. On March 24th, an academic council meeting had been planned so that scholarship amounts of 25,000 as per UGC norms should be given. It was to disrupt all of this deliberately that Appa Rao was suddenly brought in. The question we need to ask, मैंने security sir को भी पूछा जब हमने उन्होंने हमने को रोका कि ये university क्या उनके बाप की जाति है क्या? This is a place where ideas are exchanged. We are willing to debate with the Sangh Parivar ideas, but the Sangh Parivar is scared of debate and lathi. They like to have the lathi, they like to have the danda, they like to threaten, they don't like to dialogue and discuss. Because if you dialogue and discuss, maybe they will understand their own history. And the history of the Sangh Parivar is an ignominious history which collaborated with colonial powers, did not support the national struggle. On 26th of November 2015, we saw a tamasha in Parliament where Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar was sought to be appropriated. And in the Delhi Book Fair this year, when the collected works of Babasaheb Ambedkar were being sold by the central government and the Maharashtra government, 11 crucial volumes were missing. Which were the volumes that were missing? You will know better than me. You're better educated than I am. You're MPhil scholars, research scholars. Your politics is so strong. The 11 volumes that were missing were Shudras and Counter-Revolution, Women and Counter-Revolution, State and Minorities, annihilation of caste and riddles in Hinduism. So they want a sanitized Baba Saheb Ambedkar. They want an Ambedkar just to capture vote by votes, a section of the Dalit votes. We do not want a revolutionary and a radical Ambedkar who question the caste system, who question injustice caused by the caste system. And friends, anybody who believes that caste is a matter of the past, we simply have to look at a record of the number of Dalit students in higher education who have felt so alienated and have taken their own lives. So like was said by my comrade Zuhair, it was not just a question of Rohit, it's a question of Senthil, it's a question of Surajani, it's a question of so many other Dalit students who've taken their own lives because of the isolation that I felt truly ashamed when I saw the accounts of how students and faculty were treated by the police on 22nd of March and for 1 week after that. Whether it was women, whether it was Dalits, whether it was Adivasis, whether it was minorities, there was specific abuse relegated to each section. So girls and women were threatened rape. Minorities were called terrorists. Dalits were called the normal caste abuse names. And all of them were told that if you protest and have beef festivals, if you talk about kiss of love, if you talk about freedom of expression, then you'll be prepared to bear lathis and bear torture of the worst kind. We need to ask the authorities. I want to know what the Telangana government is doing. This state was founded on a lot of hope. The Telangana government cannot say that this is a central university and turn its blind eye. Hyderabad Central University is within Telangana. Telangana was formed as part of a certain struggle. Is the Telangana government going to turn its ears and eyes away from the students and the faculty who are being tortured within the city of Hyderabad? That is the question we need to ask. And finally, students, there are many other eminent speakers. I just want to say, from the day that the University of Hyderabad struggled took a radical and revolutionary form, day and night I've been in touch with all of you, trying our little way to jog the media, to jog the national community, to jog the police. And we will stand with you. It is our duty to stand with you. And I would like to appeal to all people's struggles across the country that we need to stand, not just with the University of Hyderabad and Hyderabad Central University, but wherever such struggles are on. Whether it is in FTII, whether it is in Chennai, whether it is in JNU. I personally believe that the JNU was started to divert attention from the Hyderabad Central University. Because such a momentum had been maintained after Rohit Venula's death. And today, one last question I want to ask. 70 years after independence, we are forced to ask questions on caste. It's a shame. I am forced to ask myself the question, that is this some dirty kamma politics that is going on in this university? Should our centers of learning be reduced to these kind of crass questions? You are the ones who talk about merit. You are the ones who, in the question of reservation, talk about merit. Where is this kamma equation coming from? Not only are there kamma central ministers like Venkaya Naidu, not only their kamma register, not even their kamma vice chancellor, but even the IG in Chhattisgarh is a kamma, Kaluri, where there's another kind of repression going on. What is this caste politics that is going on? The worst and the most retrograde kind of caste politics is being centered within our university academies. And in the words of Professor Senthil, this is how anti-caste struggles are going to pan out. We have to be prepared to bear the brutality of the state, and most of all, we have to learn how to stand together in our struggles. All I can say is, we are with you. Jai Bhim! Inkalab Zindabad.